Light is on. Gates have opened, they're off and they're racing. Just So Sassy, the first to commence over City Angel, and also away well is Smoky Mountain. It'll be prominent with Kripalenko. Star Power is next, and Go Go Gromit's caught out there deep in the early part. Platinum Class getting right back with Bred to Flirt. They sort themselves out going hard here at the 650. Just So Sassy leads the way by a length over City Angel. Running third over on the inside, Smoky Mountain forced to cover additional ground. Go Go Gromit in the middle is Kripalenko. Kripalenko. Star Power's got a back to follow coming to the turn, and then Platinum Class, and a clear last is Bred to Flirt on the point of the turn. Just So Sassy about a half to three quarters on the outside to City Angel, who headed it very quickly. Kripalenko giving chase, followed by Go Go Gromit, Star Power, but it's City Angel who draws away from them. 120 to go, City Angel out by more than two. Kripalenko, Star Power, Platinum Class and Bred to Flirt, but City Angel makes it a winning return. City Angel beat Kripalenko, Bred to Flirt got right up on the rails for third from Star Power, and then Platinum Class, Go Go Gromit capitulating after being deep all the way. Smoky Mountain, every hope, and knocking up Just So Sassy brings up the rear of the field after going lickety split. City Angel with Matty Derrick aboard. Number four makes it a winning return. Number four is the winner, City Angel, in 58.08. 58.08. And winning well on return here with Jace Buckley returning to training ranks and coming up with the City winner in the form of an Angel. Matty Derrick aboard by City Place out of Flying Angel. Four wins it from five, Kripalenko, Jason Whiting, and two, Bred to Flirt, charging through along the rails from last, Luke Campbell. Star Power finishing fourth. The interim numbers are 4-5-2-6. 4-5-2-6. They've run home in 34-3-6. She was very good. She dashed past Just So Sassy as heads had turned for home, opened up, gave them no hope, and returned in great order this afternoon. And her first up card is absolutely superb. It's four first up runs, two wins, two seconds. And she's now won three from 16. For owners Dee Moore, Madame Spence, White Forest, Williams, Graham, Martin, Strano, Plowman, Falinski, and Jones, White the Lions, Pride Group, TLP Syndicate, Coughlin, Mora, and also Delmenico. Plenty of owners there, and they'll celebrate the spoils of this victory by City Angel first up this afternoon. A good result too for trainer Jace Buckley. Kripalenko second, continuing his good form. He's a machino from Brooks, me baby. Jason Whiting for Greg Buglehull, and third, Bred to Flirt by Gingerbread Man out of Naughty Affair, a mare 6 years, trained by Chris and Michael Ganjimmy and written by Luke Campbell. Money off the target with Smoky Mountain, finishing out of contention after being there prominent throughout. Race number three, the Glenroy Chaff Handicap, once again 1,000 metres, a pay 1-2, seven running in the next at 4-1. As Lockie joins us down in the yard, and a really good result here for Jace Buckley.
Certainly is, Darren, without doubt. City Angel back at the races here today. First up, first things first, Jace, the recent trial on the 15th of April. What did you make of her effort? Were you ever concerned that she might have come back quite as good?
Not really. She had a bit of a trickle last start. She had to pass a trial to get to the races. So I said to Mary, just give her a nice soft trial and, just don't bust her and just let her be comfortable and see how she pulls up. So, and she pulled up well from that. And then Maddie's been galloping her at home. So she was pretty confident today with her. So the owners pulled the right rein, leaving her in today, not running her next week, I think.
How have you viewed her progression? Obviously, she won her last start last campaign. How has she built up physically and mentally over the last 3 or 4 months?
Yeah, she's matured a lot mentally, I think, which has helped. We're just trying to see if we can take a bit more of a sit this prep, just so she's got a bit more for the end. She's sort of running a race at both ends last prep, and it was just getting her caught, especially at Belmont with the straights a bit longer. She's just getting caught that last 50. So hopefully we've nutted that out and can improve on it this preparation.
To the eye, it still looks like she's doing a few things wrong. I note that she's... Where's the one-eyed blinker? How's she been in that sense?
Yeah, so she's always had a tendency to lay in. So we've had the lugging bit and the one-eyed blinker on her for quite a while. And I just don't want to change it at this point in case she starts doing it again.
Where to next for her?
We'll see how she pulls up, because she did have a trickle last preparation. I wouldn't mind spacing her runs a bit, probably going 3 weeks into something on a Saturday, maybe 66 plus or something.
Great training performance here. Well done.
Thanks, mate. Appreciate it.
There's Jace Buckley after the win of City Angel. And here's Maddie Derrick catching up with Scotty.
Well, Maddie, trials are trials and races are races, and that's probably the perfect example of it.
Yeah, well, I mean, she trialled with the earmuffs on because we just wanted to give her a soft trial. But I wasn't expecting her to go that good first up. I thought she'd need the run. But once she settled nicely outside the leader, I thought she'd have enough left at the end.
Top of the home straight, that leader wasn't going to take you much further, so you basically had to go, now's the time.
Yeah, that's it. I just held her together and let her cruise up under her own steam. But once I went for her, she really found. I was quite impressed with that run.
She wanted to roll back to the fence too, had to pull the whip through to the left.
Yeah, she can. She does have the tendency to lay in. I knew that going into today, so I was prepared. But I think she's learnt to win now, and I wouldn't be surprised if those are the only races she wins.
What about later on? Look like you've got two more nice rides. Catch the red eye for Sue Olive, and later on for the Taylors in cross statement.
Yeah, they're both nice rides, and they have nice races for them, so hopefully they can get the money as well.
Congratulations, well done.
Thank you.
There's Maddie Derrick combining with Jace Buckley and City Angel to take out race number two here at Ascot.
This bad, she's got everything in her.